few final words with both athletes.
Look how tall Schoolboy is.
You can see now that Schoolboy is a big boy, isn't he?
You call that?
Well, he's coming. He's the heavier athlete. He's the taller athlete. He's got the leverage. Obviously,
musculature
is with Larry. But the experience, even though he's young, is still with Schoolboy in this match.
Without a doubt, Loss. And Larry is about to feel the
close your thumbs.
He's about to get that first hit, and that's the important.
Do not move, gentlemen.
If Larry
do
can
not
get
move.
The brakes on early,
do not cover your knuckles when
match.
I close your hands.
But he needs
close your
to
hands.
Stop it. He needs to slow it down. Huge drive, and Schoolboy breaks the hand.
He's laying down a message there.
Schoolboy just took the hand and wrist of Wheels and sat up. Little dominant. And that's that real
look
match
at the
experience.
There. Yeah. Look at the confidence. Ooh.
Now, look at the distance between Larry's wrist and the arm of Schoolboy. He kept Larry's arm at bay. He created distance where there is none. He hit into the hand of Larry and then pronated hard. And that creates a gap. And that gap, whilst it was only small, increases his leverage exponentially as the match progresses. And we saw the evidence of that there. It was a crushing win for Schoolboy.
15 seconds,
he
gentlemen.
Looked outstanding. Now, Coach Ray is going to be working hard in Larry's corner, but my concern is,
time.
With the best intention in the world, it's very difficult to get that kind, that level of expertise into anyone with practice alone.
Absolutely. There's, you know, in all sports, it's about being match ready. And this is, you know, jumping into the deep end for
Urban.
Essentially, in terms of competitive experience, a novice. We all know how strong he is. You know, we've seen the lifts. We've seen the people he's been against.
Close your hands.
Do not blink, ladies and gentlemen. Big drive. And that's the strap, and it was intentional.
So do you think this can help then?
It can help a great deal.
He's going to be able to access that.
But my concern is that it's not going to help a great deal. I believe that, if anything, Schoolboy is more experienced in the strap than he is outside of the strap. A lot of people, he's going to blaze through their hand and wrist in his everyday arm wrestling experiences. He is happy in the strap. Larry may not be.
Okay, open, gentlemen. Okay, center. Close your thumbs. Close your hands.
Now needs
he
to commit.
A win here.
Big drive, but Schoolboy still comfortable. Larry got a little purchase there, and this is better from Larry. Much better. But Schoolboy again able to finish it. I'll tell you what, though.
Yes. He got more respect from Schoolboy that time.
Yeah, that was far better. Much, much better from Larry. Schoolboy at a little moment of concern there.
Yeah,
and he rushed himself.
There wasn't the same confidence that he had in the first round.
Not at all. He drove hard himself, and he drove a little too early himself. But fundamentally, you can see the amount of effort having to be put in there by Schoolboy and having to be put in there by Larry.
Yeah.
And the difference is that Larry is on the absolute red line. He couldn't give any more.
Do you think sometimes, in that situation, sometimes it's better to give up that round and come back a bit fresher on the next one? Or
you know what, Lawrence, I don't believe that it would make any difference.
Yeah.
I think it's just purely and simply the experience gap is vast.
This is Alex's brother with him there, looking after him. Another great arm wrestler himself.
He is. Alex Pozaikov is a fabulous arm wrestler, but the problem is that
your distance okay?
I don't think he needs to give much advice at this stage. I don't think there's a great deal that can happen that's going to make it any different.
Yeah. 15 seconds, gentlemen.
So they've got 15 seconds to hook up again. And now Larry's going to be one of taking every one of those seconds.
Time.
He really is, mate.
Go.
Larry's going to be feeling it. He's really going to be feeling this big time.
I guess that's one of the disadvantages of having such huge muscles, is that you burn through that lactic acid quickly.
Elbows down.
Or the lactic acid builds up quickly. And in terms of endurance, you can lose that center power quickly. Yeah.
Open.
Larry is used to powerlifting. One rep. All out explosive power. He wants to be winning these matches within a couple of seconds. Anything beyond that,
close,
he's going to drain quickly.
Go!
Big drive again from Larry, but nothing doing there. And Schoolboy completely dominating the hand and wrist.
You're moving in front of the replay camera, so they can't see the replay.
Look at the hand dominance there. And what's most important there is how intuitive Schoolboy is. You can see that experience. He's not having to think through the movement. It's there for him. He's just moving, reacting, and he's already got control of the match. Larry is feeling his way in the dark. This is new territory for him, and it's extremely difficult for him to find a foothold in the match. The strap may assist, but at this point in time, that experience gap is the difference between these men.
Do you think it would be good for someone like Larry, who clearly has great potential, to enter some competitions and get experience against lots of different arm wrestlers?
100% lost. What Larry's lacking is not strength, it's not physicality, it's not potential. He's got all of those things, but what he doesn't have is match feeling. He doesn't have familiarity with the position.
Yeah.
And that's what he's lacking here. And
risk.
Schoolboy at this point in time has been able to put a couple of serious hits into him, take away all of Larry's power,
thumbs down,
neutralize it in an instant, and from there,
wrist.
Larry's panicking and he's unable to recover his position.
Close hands.
When he does so, it's nothing like what he's experienced
one
in training.
Okay.
You feel for Larry Wheels. I'd love to see him get something in this match, but he's facing an extremely tricky opponent.
Yeah, an experienced opponent that already has the height advantage, the weight advantage.
Close your hands.
And
go!
Years more training in the sport.
Oh,
fast hit there.
Oh,
big,
oh,
big
boy. Sweet child of mine.
And unfortunately, this is looking ominous right now.
Yeah, it's very, very difficult to see Larry getting punished up there like that. He's just not able to find a foothold.
How many we got?
I feared that might be the case for him. Schoolboy's an extremely tricky individual.
I'm not keeping track of that, so.
What round is this?
The Schoolboy needs to stay focused as well. He doesn't want
to
loosen up, you know, he doesn't want to let Larry access that power because, you know, he's such a strong man. So he needs to stay on top of him and hit hard. He's doing exactly what he needs to do.
He really is. I mean, let's be honest. Schoolboy came to Dubai to win an arm wrestling match, and right now he's doing exactly that. You can't knock the man. He's doing exactly what he came to do, and he's doing it well, and he's doing it impressively. And right now he's dismantling his opponent. That was a comfortable victory. He what we call bone lined Larry there. He took him out of position very, very early. Most arm wrestlers, when they start the sport, they're arm wrestling is done in straight lines. It's done in lifting lines, if you will. The strength which you would believe is all
five, gentlemen.
And it's done in an isolated manner. It's not done in a joined way. You're not joining up the muscle groups. It's like almost throwing an arm punch in boxing rather than twisting your body into the movement, twisting, utilizing the shape. That's what we're seeing here from Larry. He just isn't able to piece the disparate elements together.
Thumbs down.
Schoolboy.
Close your hands.
Cruising at the moment.
Go!
May slow it down a little bit. Dominates the hand again. It's over.
And it's another quick win.
Turning into a very, very difficult night for Larry Wheels.
We don't need an extra, do we?
In arm wrestling, even now he's got the win. They still finish off the six matches.
You know what? If I was Schoolboy at this stage, I would just jump into a hook with Larry. I'm going to be honest with you. He's nothing to lose.
Yeah.
He's already
Test
got the match.
In a different
I'd assist
element.
The guy. I would assist the guy at this stage, and I'd let Larry get where he's comfortable. Let him have a little feel, get a little bit of movement and experience in there. And hopefully Alex does that. Hopefully he doesn't just whitewash it. I'd love to see him right now just jump into that hook, let Larry find his feet. I hope that Larry hasn't put it too many miles on the clock and that he's unable to recover anything from the match,
sure.
You know, just get a feel from it. Because at the moment he's not had a chink of daylight, and it's a bit soul-destroying. It's hard for anybody to swallow that, and particularly for someone like Larry, who is such a competitive individual in so many environments.
I think it's important to understand that Larry is still very much a novice when it comes to this sport.
Yeah.
You know, it's easy for us to watch his YouTube and see him training with the likes of Devon or Michael Todd or whoever it might be. But in terms of competitive experience, he's hardly had a match.
Were you on this side last time?
You know, I know from the little bit of arm wrestling I've done myself, I'm looked at as a big, strong man, so people expect this. There is so much to arm wrestling that he still needs to learn.
Both agree to the strap.
Hopefully this experience doesn't put him off too much.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you. One of my concerns was exactly that. Before the start of the match, I did feel that Schoolboy represents an extremely difficult opponent. Of all the opponents that could have been selected for Larry, Schoolboy is a very difficult one because he's an elusive opponent. He's not the type of guy who is accessible, and he's not the type of guy who is going to come into the position on the table that favours Larry or Larry's comfortable in. He's an opposing style.
You'd like to see Larry against, say, like a hook?
I would. I'd like to see someone who'd come and meet Larry head on, allow him to use the power. You know, if you were planning Larry's career,
close
for me, I would put him against someone who's not going to take away his power. A little better. Now you go.
He's looking better this time.
Yeah. Alex has done this on purpose. He's allowed Larry to get into the match, and he's letting him pull a little, letting him try and find some position. But Alex is in control, staying with it now and tightening down, and there's the pin. That was better.
That's what you expected to happen.
Yes, right. I did. And you can see that Schoolboy is acknowledging there that Larry's got a lot of horsepower. But what's evident is Larry, even in that position, is moving out of his strength, and I think he may have damaged something there.
He said he's done that.
Yeah, I think he may have tweaked something there. What he means there is he's gone to the absolute red line, past the elastic limit.
Oh, I've had a few sparring sessions and I've been there where you just have nothing left.
I'm not sure we're going to see Larry contest the last round. I think he may have tweaked something there.
On the way he did in the last few months.
Clearly, Schoolboy has been training hard these last few months.
Yeah, Schoolboy's early 20s. He's actually younger than I thought he was. I thought he was like mid-20s. He's early 20s, 21
years
old. He's an evolving force himself.
He's got to be an exciting prospect for us.
Without question, mate. I mean, you've got to remember with Schoolboy, this guy is coming up through one of the most difficult arm wrestling nations on earth. Russia is a dominant force in the world of arm wrestling. And to be perfectly honest, if you can make it in Russia, you can make it anywhere. And
time, gentlemen.
Schoolboy is the real deal.
So final round.
Yeah, I don't know whether we're going to see anything from Larry.
So going straight into the strap.
Yeah, I think Schoolboy will let it go anywhere now. I think he's going to allow Larry to pull. I would. I think most guys with this kind of dominance in the match would have just allow Larry to take it where he wants it and then sort of shape and move to him. And I hope that we see that from Schoolboy. I hope that he allows Larry to do that. Unfortunately, I think Larry's gone to the bank and there's not a lot left there now.
Open.
Schoolboy there, baby-faced assassin. Looks like he's literally just come back off his paper round, but to be perfectly honest, the man is a serial killer.
I think he was weighing in close to 280 pounds, I think.
He's a big boy.
Thumbs down.
Let's Close see if hand. He does allow
Go!
Larry to access the strength. He's beating, taking away the power this time. Larry has nothing in the match there. He just doesn't have any purchase point. I got a feel for Larry Wheels there, Loss. It's hard to watch that.
It's tough. But I think, like I said to you, Neil, it's important that we all understand that Larry is still very much a novice in this sport. And it takes years, not just for the strength, because arm wrestling is a unique strength. Well. I mean, people say it's all just technique. It's really not. The strength that some of these arm wrestlers have in certain areas. You know, if this was a powerlifting contest, Larry is going to wipe the floor with Schoolboy.
Yeah, you'd be looking at the same level of dominance that we've just seen from Schoolboy on an arm wrestling table.
Different skill set, different muscle groups that are used.